Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hi everybody, welcome to NTAB. This is Lena, and in today's class we are going to discuss adverb, okay, and its application. And you will definitely see questions in your bank examination based on this topic, okay? So adverb, what do you understand by adverb? Okay, I have already told you in the previous classes about what adjective, right? We have discussed about adjective. What is the function of an adjective? It qualifies a noun or a pronoun, or you can say it tells something more, or it describes a noun or a pronoun. But what is the function of an adverb? It qualifies a verb, an adjective, and another adverb. Okay, this is the difference between adjective and adverb. So you can see the definition: an adverb modifies a verb, an adjective, and another adverb, right? So modifies or qualifies means, modify and qualify means it tells something more, okay, about what a verb, an adjective, or adverb. So we have some examples, and I will tell you about the usage of adverb. First sentence is, Kavya danced beautifully. So Kavya is the subject, we all know that. I hope you know that. Dance is the second form of the verb. Now what is beautifully? Beautifully is not an object. Why? Because a noun or a pronoun can be an object, okay? But beautifully is not a noun, not a pronoun, so this cannot be an object. So when I say Kavya danced beautifully, if I say how Kavya danced, it means it gives the answer of how beautifully, okay? The way she danced, this word beautifully defines that. So this beautifully is an adverb which qualifies this verb. Okay, she did something, she danced, and the way she danced, elaborating by the adverb, and that is beautifully. Clear? Second sentence, Kavya is a beautiful dancer. So Kavya is the subject, she is the verb, dancer is the subject complement basically, but a noun, right? Dancer is a noun. When we call a name of any profession, that is a noun. Actor, dancer, singer, all these things are noun. Now what is this beautiful? Beautiful noun, this is noun, and it is talking about, or it is qualifying the dancer, so we cannot call it an adverb. Now what is this? Is an adjective, okay? This is adjective, but beautifully is an adverb. I hope it's clear to you. Now third sentence is, Kavya is the subject, is the verb, is a very beautiful dancer. So dancer is the noun, beautiful is an adjective. Now what is this? Very, she is a beautiful dancer, but very is qualifying beautiful, which is an adjective. And an adverb can only qualify, an adverb can qualify an adjective. So very is the adjective, right? So it can qualify a verb, like in this sentence, it can qualify an adjective, like in this sentence, okay? Now last sentence, Kavya danced very beautifully. So Kavya is the subject, dance is the verb, beautifully is an adverb, okay? So Kavya danced beautifully, but this very is qualifying this adverb, okay? It's elaborating this adverb. So an adverb can modify or qualify another adverb. So very is the adverb here. So So it can also qualify or modify another adverb. I hope it's clear. Now we have some more examples like he walks slowly. Slowly is an adverb. Sonia works really hard. Sonia works what? Hard. Really hard. So what do you call it? Hard is the adjective or an adverb here. She, Sonia works. How does she work hard? So this is an adverb here, and really is also an adverb here because it is qualifying this hard. Both the words really and hard are adverbs here. So face is extremely red. So red is what? It's an adjective, and extremely is an adverb. Now the baby crawled very slowly. Okay. Slowly is an adverb here because it is qualifying this verb, and very is an adverb because it is qualifying another adverb, that is slowly. Now let's talk about types of adverb. Okay. So we have different types of adverbs, and it is important to understand its function. Okay. Why? Because you will see a lot of questions based on adverb. Now we have adverbs of manner. Understand carefully and understand deeply about these types. So the manner or the way in which something happens. Okay. Let's say the example is she speaks slowly, right? So if I say how does she speak, okay? If I ask this question, how does she speak? You will say she speaks slowly. It means it is giving you the answer of how. But at the same time, it is telling you the way in which something has happened. So when you call adverbs of manner, adverbs of manner gives you the answer of how. Sohan helped us cheerfully. How he helped us cheerfully. So slowly is an adverb. Adverb of manner. Cheerfully is again an adverb of manner. Okay, now next type we have is adverbs of place. So whenever we talk about place, it's give you the answer of where. Okay, where, the place where something happens. So we looked everywhere. Where did we look? Where did we look? So everywhere is the answer of where. Two cars were parked outside. Okay. Two cars were parked outside. So two cars were parked. Okay. Where? Outside. So outside is giving you the answer of where. So we have adverbs of manner, which gives you the answer of how. We have adverbs of place, which gives you the answer of where. Clear? Now adverbs of time. Okay. Now let's talk about adverbs of time. The time when something happens. Okay, it means it gives you the answer of when. Alright, so it gives you the answer of when. So he came here yesterday. He came here when? Now see, yesterday is giving you the answer of when. So yesterday, tomorrow, today, all these things are adverbs and gives you the answer of when. Okay, he came here when? When did he come? Yesterday. So they deliver the newspaper daily. So daily is giving you the answer of when. That is why this is adverbs of time. Okay, and it is giving you the answer of when. Now adverbs of degree. Now let's talk about adverbs of degree. So adverbs of degree will give you the answer of how much. Alright. It means the degree or extent to which something happens. Like Sheena entirely agrees with him. Okay. So Sheena agrees with him. That is fine. But entirely, how much? She agrees, but how much? Entirely. Entirely is the adverb of degree. Okay, which gives the answer of how much. He drove quite dangerously. So he drove dangerously and quite. So which is the adverb of degree? So he drove dangerously, that is your adverb. But How much? Quite. So this is the word which gives you the answer of how much. Okay. He drove. This is your subject and this is your verb. This is your adverb. Dangerously is your adverb. But how much? Quite. Alright. Entirely and quite. These kind of words gives you the answer of how much, and that is why they are called adverbs of degree. Now moving further, adverbs of frequency are there also. So adverbs of degree gives you the answer of how much. Do you understand the word frequency? When you say what is the frequency of metro on this line? For instance, what is the frequency of metro on red line, on yellow line? So it means it tells you that how many times any particular action occurs. Okay, any particular action happens. So how many times any action or the action occurs or occurred or will occur. It means whenever you are talking about present, past or future, it doesn't matter. But adverbs of frequency tells you about how often or how many times something happens or occurs. And some words are like daily, sometimes, often, seldom, usually, frequently, always, ever, generally, monthly, rarely, yearly. These kind of words gives you the answer of how often. Alright, so they can be called adverbs of frequency. We have this statement. He is always late for class. So always is adverb of frequency. He is late for class. How often or how many times? So it gives you the answer of how often. That is always. The employees are paid monthly. Right? So monthly is the adverb here. Adverb of frequency. The employees are paid every month. Okay? Every month. What is the adverb of frequency here? Every month is the adverbs of frequency. He never smokes, never is the adverb. Barking dogs seldom bite, seldom is the adverb. Alright, so we have understood all these types. We have one more type of adverb, that is reason. So whenever there is a reason, gives you the answer of what? Why? Yes. Gives you the answer of why, a reason for something to happen. Okay, so hence, therefore, on account of, consequently, all these things are adverbs of reason, right? Now we have this sentence, I could not come because I was not well. So because is giving you what? I could not come because I was not well. So because is giving you the answer of why. Yes. I do not like him. He has cheated many people. So since is giving you the answer of why. I don't like him. Why? Because since he has cheated many people. Now we have some examples for you. Okay. So one by one, I will explain each sentence and you also try to find out the error. Okay. We have four sentences and you can find some kind of error in each sentence, and it will be also possible that you will not find any kind of error in any sentence. The first sentence is, Kabir is being very politely for the reason best known to him. Okay, so this is your sentence. Can you find any kind of error in this sentence? Kabir is being very politely for the reason best known to him. So, because we are talking about adverbs, can you find out where is the adverb in this sentence? Kabir is being very, very is an adverb, we all know. We have already talked about very, very is an adverb. And what about politely? What do you think about politely? Kabir is very being politely for the reason best known to him. This is politely and this word is an adverb. But is this the correct usage of this word here? Okay. Can you say that politely is the correct word for this place? What if I say Kabir is being very polite? The reason best known to him. See what happens? when you are using politely and it is an adverb, okay, so it means it is talking about a verb or an adjective or an adverb, right? But this particular word is not talking about verb, adjective or adverb. It is talking about Kabir. Okay, so if we write this example like this, Kabir is very polite. Okay, is this the correct sentence? Or you would say Kabir is very polite? No, because we need an adjective here, not adverb. And when we use an adjective in this context, this is the subject complement. Okay? Kabir is polite. Is the linking verb when we use be forms, is, am, are, was, were, as at the place of main verb. They are linking verbs basically, and what they do, they connect subject with its complement. So basically this is a subject complement, but we need an adjective. Okay? Subject complement can be adjectives or noun. So we need adjective here, not noun. So this is the error in this part. You cannot write politely here. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, next sentence we have, I did not know hardly anyone in the college, and so I felt lonely all the time. So I did not know hardly. I'll talk about this word in the next part or the next class. But as of now, what is the meaning of hardly? See, we have two words. One is hard and another one is hardly. Okay, I'll explain in detail in next class. But as of now, understand that hard can be used as adjective and adverb as well. Okay, and hardly is an adverb. But what is the difference between these two words? Hardly means when something is very difficult to do. No, when something is very difficult to happen. Okay, or you could say rarely, when something happens rarely, not usually. Okay, when something happens or when something is done by someone rarely. This is the meaning of hardly. Okay, you can say hard work, she worked really hard. You can say she works really hard, she works hard. But you cannot say she works hardly. When you say she works hardly, it means she really works. Okay, she generally does time pass, she doesn't do anything, she rarely do anything. Okay, she rarely does anything. So this is the difference between hard. Do you understand? Hard means hard work. Okay, when you are putting your effort, this is the meaning of hard. And hardly means when something happens rarely. Can we use hardly here? I did not know hardly anyone. Maybe this sentence is talking about anyone, or this sentence is modifying anyone. So if a word which modifies another noun or pronoun, it has to be an adjective, okay, not noun. So I do not know, or I did not know hardly anyone in the college. Is this perfectly fine or not? So next we have, and so I felt lonely all the time. Okay, so understand this example. Is this talking about an adjective, or do we need an adjective here? No, we do not need adjective here. What happens if you say I did not know anyone, I did not know anyone, that is fine. And if you say I know, or I hardly know anyone, that is also fine. Yes. So what is the problem? Hardly is not inappropriate in that way. But what happens, because hardly has the negative meaning. Okay, hardly, scarcely, seldom, these are the verb adverbs which has negative meaning. Okay, which has negative essence. So you cannot use negative with hardly. Okay, so you can say I did not know anyone. In that case, simply delete hardly. Hardly is an adverb, but an adverb is not required here. Why? Because an adverb of negation, okay? A negative adverb is not required here because we already have did not. Or you can say I hardly know anyone, that is also fine, but in that case you have to remove did not. Okay, so these are the things you need to keep in your mind. A third sentence is saying his speech was clearly, but I understood the underlying meaning. Okay, I think it's clear. His speech was not clearly or clear. We need clear here, not clearly. His speech was not clear, but I understood the underlying meaning. The fourth one, Sameer behaved very bad on the trip. Bad is an adjective here. It is an adjective here, but we need what? An adverb. So convert it into badly. Okay. Sameer behaved how? Badly. Very badly. Very is an adverb which is qualifying badly. Okay. This is about it. Now, if you want to, participate in daily vocabulary quiz, you can simply download Entry app. If you do not have this app, if you have it, then that is perfectly fine. And simply click on the Hindu vocab. Once you click on it, you will see this kind of page where you will see day wise vocabulary. Okay, you can pick any day, 87, 80, 90, 100, any day. Once you click on day, on any particular day, you will see this kind of page. See, if you click on day 86, you will see this kind of page where you will have five vocabulary questions, for which you will get 3 minutes. It means you will have 3 minutes to attempt these 5 questions, only 3 minutes, and 20 marks you will get for these 5 questions if you have answered all of the 5 questions correctly. And after that, what you will see, analytics, where you will see how much did you attempt correctly or how much did you correct incorrectly, how much did you attempt incorrectly. So you will see this kind of data of your performance. Okay, you can also practice subject wise. That means you can also practice questions per section you have in your examination. Like suppose simply click on subjects, you will see these kind of subjects like English, professional knowledge, quantitative aptitude, general awareness, all these things. If you click on English, you will see this kind of page, and here you can change your examination or the name of your examination. I will be SPO prelims, SPA PO prelims, SPA clerk, and so on. And you have this kind of things where you can practice questions, whatever you want. So this is all about it. If you like the video, hit the like button. And if you have any kind of query, you can write in the comment box. Also share this class with your friends who are also preparing for banking examination. Thanks for watching and keep learning.